understand. Are you strong enough to be my man? My man. Nothing's true.
Eastern states of Australia.
Of the eastern states.
Eastern
yes.
states, am I correct? Now, I don't. You've just arrived in this country, so you wouldn't
yes.
know about the musical
no,
challenge.
No, I've been hearing about it though.
Do you want to hold your CD? Because in here are 50 of the worst songs of all time, one of which I'm going to challenge you and your band with. Are you prepared to take this challenge?
I'd love to.
Just
I have,
as well,
I haven't
Horace.
Written any of the 50 of the worst tunes.
Oh, no, yes, one. No. No. Okay, here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
That's the sound my arm makes. That's the scary thing. Oh, uh-oh. It's Ooh. Something special. It's karaoke roulette. Ah! Are you a big, are you a big karaoke singer, Sheryl?
As long as there's the bouncing ball and the lyrics, I can hang.
We can guarantee you a bouncing ball and lyrics if you'll guarantee
right.
us some karaoke.
I'm in there.
Anything? Oh, this could be very ugly, ladies and gentlemen. Sheryl Crow coming up shortly. But in the meantime, some indispensable advice from Amanda Keller.
Living with Amanda.
Still unbelievable.
Unbelievable?
Yeah.
Just a blur?
Just a big blur. Just one long evening of nausea.
Nausea? Really?
I can't wait for it to be over.
Why?
Isn't that awful?
Why?
It's very intimidating being surrounded by people you grew up idolizing and...
Oh, please, look, we're friends. Come on.
Well... I think it was the 3 weeks beforehand about wearing what I was going to wear.
Had you practiced the look on your face if you didn't win?
Me?
No, that's if you did win. What if you didn't win?
It was more...
Oh, Because I read that you were a bit of a nerdy type when you grew up. Is that right?
No.
No, it's not right?
Do I look like...
No, you don't. No, sorry.
I was actually. I was very shy. Kind of backward.
Kind of backward?
Well...
But you played the banjo.
Does that mean something other...
No.
Does that mean something other than Australia than it does in the United States?
No. It means exactly the same thing.
I was nerdy, yes.
Nerdy, so...
Read books. A lot.
That's not nerdy. That's okay. And so there you were at the Grammys, the coolest person in the whole universe for a night. Was that uncomfortable for you as a nerdy type?
You know, I need to go back and watch the actual footage of it. I haven't seen any of it, so... having a lot of cameras on you, well, you're not intimidated by it, but it was very nerve-wracking.
Really?
And playing in front of Peter Gabriel and Bonnie Raitt and all these different people, all I could think about was whether I had food in my teeth or I had some weird expression on my face.
So what, if you have food in your teeth, you're hoping to share with some of them afterwards, weren't you?
Make sure I can get it out.
Could you actually, were you conscious of them when you were singing? Could you see
Peter
Gabriel there?
Yes, they were right under my nose, so.
That's very rude.
Well, I got to see what everyone was wearing.
Oh, was anyone better dressed than you?
Oh, absolutely not.
No. Sorry.
No, actually, I don't know. I'm not a very good dresser, so.
Oh, okay. You seem to have low self-esteem.
Oh, I guess I do, don't I?
Welcome to Uncle Andy's couch session.
And darn it, people like me.
They do, and I can see why.
I'm kidding.
You're a very charming, natural person.
Well.
Now, your father played trumpet on this album, the Tuesday Night Music Club. Who was more nervous when he came in to record, you or him?
He was a wreck.
Really?
Absolutely. It took two months of constant phone calling. In fact, prank phone calling at 4:30 in the morning. Go play on your daughter's record. You owe it to her. Anyway, no, it did. Actually, 2 months of constant barrage of phone calls.
Why didn't he want to do it?
Well, he hadn't played in about 20 years. And, maybe he has low self-esteem also.
Maybe it's genetic. Well, it's interesting because you, in your before becoming Sheryl Crow solo act, you were...
Before I was Sheryl Crow?
Yes, before you were Sheryl Crow.
I think that's funny.
In that early time, you were a backup singer for Michael Jackson on his Bad Tour, which involved...
We were here.
Here?
Right here.
Right, good grief.
No,
every night you had to go out and do a love duet with him. What was that like?
Can I tell a nasty story about it?
Absolutely.
Can I? Well, I'll tell you what it was like. First, let me preface the story by saying I toured with him for 18 months, and he didn't actually learn any of our names for about 9 months of that, so I didn't have a great relationship with him. I actually didn't have a relationship with him, but...
You were probably about 20 years too old. Shame on me. Sorry, go on.
Anyway, we digress. What was my story? Anyway, we used to start sort of in the middle of the band, and then we'd sort of wind up in front of the rhythm section, and the bass player and the drummer would put money on every night whether Michael became aroused during the middle of the duet. And he used to wear very tight, slick, sort of shiny pants. Anyway, I'm sorry you asked.
I did ask her. I got more than I asked for. Did he?
I don't know. I'm telling you, about 9 months into it, I found out about the joke. I had no idea.
Really?
I mean, I'm sure he's fully equipped and all, but... it wasn't anything that was really... I don't know. It didn't seem too relevant to what we were doing.
So much nicer to be a solo act, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Not have to do all that. Did you?
Because, to be female.
You're not an overnight success. It's been a 10 years overnight success. Did you ever despair that you weren't going to make it?
No, I didn't. This may sound ridiculous, but I didn't set out to sort of make it. I more or less wanted to be able to make... I wanted to pay my rent doing something I loved, and that's kind of what I've been doing for a long time. So to make it to this level was not something I planned.
Well, you have my total envy playing music for a living. And
it's great fun.
Oh, I'd love it. And it's as an example of how far you've made it, now is your chance, Sheryl Crow, to play Karaoke Roulette! You look fabulous, you really do. Come on over to the karaoke machine. Now we have here, here's your microphone, and here's mine, should you need a withering harmony.
Excellent.
Now, the reason we call it roulette is there's any number of songs here. I don't know which one you're going to get. It could be the Folsom Prison Blues.
Ooh.
The Candyman, what a wonderful song that is. To All the Girls I'd Love Before, who knows which one
to
it will
all
be.
All the Girls I'd Love.
Ah, yes, so let's press this button and see what we get. Sheryl Crow, your karaoke... Can't take my eyes off of you.
I love that song.
Take it away, Sheryl. This is gonna be emotional, I can tell.
I usually like to have an outfit like nipple tassels and high heels on when I do this.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be too like heaven, excuse me, to touch. I wanna hold you so much at long last, love has arrived.
Tell me, Sheryl.
And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of Andrew.
Oh.
Let's put money on whether Andrew's getting
you'd
aroused.
Be like... You'd be as long as love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.